Hello, I'm the Thunkable Beaver, and welcome to Thunkable, the platform where anyone can build their own mobile apps without having to code. To help get you started, we've created tutorial courses for beginner, intermediate, and advanced app building. In these tutorials, we're going to build a lot of fantastic apps together, and we believe that your apps can change the world. Let's get started. On Thunkable.com, click the Sign In button located on the top right-hand corner of the screen, over here. When signing in, you will have the option to sign in with a Gmail account, and if you don't have a Gmail account, they're free and really easy to sign up for. This brings you to your very own project list page. This page houses all of your apps, and because this is your first app, you don't have any apps yet. That's what this tiny box is saying. Thank you, tiny box. Good form. On the upper left-hand corner, let's click Create New App to get started. And let's call our first app, App 1, My First App. Now click OK. This is the App Designer page, where you can build and design your apps. On the left side, you have the App Palette. This section has all of the cool things that you can add into your app. And on the right side, you have the Properties section, where you can customize what everything looks like. And if you have any questions about what everything does, go to docs.thunkable.com for a complete overview. And finally, this is the Blocks section. We'll come back to the blocks later, but this section allows you to easily tell your app what to do. Now, before we start building, take out your phone and go to the Google Play Store. Search for Thunkable and select the Thunkable app. This fella right here, hello. Go ahead and download this app. The Thunkable app allows you to send your apps directly to your phone and test them in real time. And for this to work, your phone and computer must be on the same Wi-Fi network so that they can talk to each other. When you've downloaded the app and you're ready to start building, select Test, which is located right over here, and then Thunkable Live over here. Notice how this generates a QR code on your screen. With the Thunkable app on your phone, go ahead and scan your QR code. Here we go. We select Scan QR Code on the Thunkable app, and we go ahead and scan the QR code on the computer. And now we wait, and our app can be tested right on our phone. Live testing is temporary, but if you actually want to download the app on your phone, select Export right over here. Or you can save the app to your computer as an APK file over here. Ready to build your first app? This app will be pretty simple. When you click a button, the color and text will change. Here's a demonstration. To get started, go to the User Interface section on the left-hand side. Drag and drop a button, over here, into the phone on the screen. Nice work! Now let's change what the button looks like. First, let's give the button a new name. Click the Rename button, over here, and let's rename it Click Me Button. Absolutely gorgeous. Over here, we can change the button's color. Let's change the button's color to green. Let's also go ahead and make the button's font bold by clicking this. And we can change the font size over here. Let's go ahead and change that to 18. Very good, very good. Let's also change the font typeface to monospace. There we go. And you can also change the height and width of the button itself. Now, we have a few options for changing the height and width. So let's go into height over here. And if you decide to select Fill Parent for height, the button's height will be the full height of the entire screen. And that looks like this. Or you could decide to choose pixels, which are small digital units. And you would pick pixels if you have a specific number of pixels in mind. I just said pixels 3 times in one sentence. That's a fun word to say. Pixels. Yes, pixels. It's a good word. Now, you can also select percent, which will change the height of the button to a percentage of the screen that it takes up. And let's go with this one, percent. Let's go ahead and make it 50%.
Yes, very good, very good.
Now we'll go ahead and select Width. And for Width, we're going to select Fill Parent, which, as we know, will fill the complete width of the screen.
Yes.
Now we can also change the button shape over here, and let's select Rounded, which will round out the edges of the button.
Brilliant, brilliant. We've done a lot with the button. Now let's change the screen.
So under Components over here, let's select Screen 1. And the first thing that we're going to do is put the button in the middle of the screen. And to do this, it's very simple. Go to Align Vertical over here, and let's select Center 2. Great. So now the button is in the middle of the screen. And we're also going to change the screen's background color, which we can do over here. Let's go ahead and change that to blue. And let's also change the screen's title. And you can do this by scrolling down to the title section over here. And let's change the title name to My First App. My First App. Great. And you see how that updates over here. Great work. Lastly, let's change the title bar color to black.
Brilliant! Now we've designed your app, let's tell it what to do. So click on the block section right over here.
Now we've created these blocks that snap together like puzzle pieces. Each block represents code, so by putting the blocks together, you will be doing the same thing as coding. To get started, on the left-hand side, you have the many options for different app functions. And let's start with our button. So go ahead and select the Click Me button right here. And let's select the first block. It says, when Click Me button dot click. And we're going to drag and drop it into the block's editor over here. Now, this block says, when the Click Me button is clicked, do something. And what do we want to do? We want the button's color to change. So what you're going to do is go back into the options for the Click Me button, and we're going to scroll to this block, which says Set Click Me button dot background color to, and we're just going to drag and drop it over to the other block and put it right in. You hear that noise? Why, that's a thunk. Good form. Now, what do we want to change the color to? We can do that by going to the color section over here, and we're going to select the color red. So click, drag, and drop the red block into the block opening over here. Very good. So now when the Click Me button is clicked, the background color will turn red. Great. Let's add one more step. Let's make it so that when you click the button, the text of the button also changes. This is very simple to do. Just go back into the options for the Click Me button, and we're going to scroll down to this block right here. It says, Set Click Me button dot text to. Yes. So go ahead and drag and drop it right under the previous block. So to see the options for text, because we want to change the text, go to the text section over here. And we are going to select the very first one, which is an empty text bar. So drag and drop it right into the opening of this block over here. And this allows us to change the text to anything. So let's have it say, I just made my first app. Great. So this combination altogether says, when the Click Me button is clicked, the background color will change to red, and the text will change to, I just made my first app. And, well, congratulations! You've just made your first app. And all of these updates have been happening in real time on your phone. So go to your phone, click the button, and the colors and text will change. Fantastic work! In our next tutorial, we will be making an app that has screaming goats. See you next time, and thanks for thunking!